After Forum for Democratic Change Secretary General Nandala Mafabi issued a letter disowning the National Consultative Meeting at Sharing Hall in Zambia, some defiant party members led by the Chira Municipality MP Ibrahim Semuju Nganda went ahead to hold the meeting. What transpired at this meeting was a testament to the internal wrangles that have continued to haunt the once number one opposition party. At 9 a.m., party supporters clad in FDC party colors, blue, started making their way inside the hall, dancing to party music. Of the 140 National Executive Committee members of the party, 120 were present, among them Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago and Harold Kaija, the party deputy secretary general. Semuju insisted that the meeting was necessary to restore the pride of FDC and redirect it to its core mission. He accused party leaders of trying to sign a deal with the NRM government.
That he is going to install a Mawaraike leadership whose main objective is to carry the party to Museveni. I am saying this without contradiction. You see, for me, I believe in FDC. Even when I lost an election as a chairman for General Moon, I went back to serve, and nobody can complain that I have not served. I went with all my energy to serve this party, and nobody can blackmail me.
Semuju accused the party leaders of failing to organize party elections and said the party had been receiving a lot of money without accountability.
I have consulted many of them. The Honorable Ngeto has just come back. has just arrived. There are many MPs. I consulted many of them. Some are out of the country. I also told the party president that as a person, I intend to carry out consultation starting today throughout the country. Because this is what he has been doing. We don't have Nandala Mafabi. You hear them, they are here, and it is not a crime, they should go ahead. We will also do the same.
Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago urged fellow FDC members to stop internal bickering, but rather get back to their core objectives of taking over the leadership of the country.
Colleagues, I want to ask you, I want you to sharpen your tools, get prepared, and get strategies for dealing with the situation at hand.
I'm so glad that today a statement is made. You people have made a statement today. I've always heard people peddling lies, people saying, peddling a fallacy, that our side is weak. The side for truth and justice is weak. Are we weak? Are we weak?
At the party headquarters in Najjanankumbi, party leaders, being stung by Semuju's group, held a parallel meeting and addressed the press. The party's electoral commission chairperson, Bamwenda Toterebuka, condemned MP Semuju Nganda for going against the party rules and regulations by organizing a consultative meeting without permission. FDC party president Patrick Amuriat Oboi responded to the confusion in the party and allegations that he was a sellout.
The leadership of the party, being respectful to our founding father, we went to him and we held a series of meetings, produced to him evidence of what he called evidence of the source of money that was used during the initial stages of our campaign. He didn't believe this. He told us he had credible evidence, and you know, we've been talking to each other for the last 3 years.
The internal bickering and split within the FDC party have not started today. This was witnessed shortly after the hotly contested party elections in November 2017, where the Besigye-backed candidate Patrick Amuriat Oboi defeated the incumbent General Mugisha Muntu for the party presidency. In September 2018, Muntu and a litany of his supporters announced that they were parting ways with the FDC party, citing ideological differences with the new FDC leadership. While Muntu believed in strengthening party structures for mobilization, the Amuriat Besigye camp pushed conventional confrontational approaches to regime change, such as street protests. Party General Secretary Nandale Mafabi, who Mugisha Muntu had defeated for the party presidency in 2012, was the frontline campaigner of Amuriat. Report by Aine Mbabazi Noamani and Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.